Hello Python students. In last lecture, we saw something called as data type. Each data element has a specific data type, which represents which category of data that particular value belongs to. For example, 10 over here is of type integer, 5.6 is of type float, whereas the value India is of type string. A data type of any variable can be checked using a command called type. Let's print type of I, type of F and type of S. As expected, it prints int, float and string. Now, in this particular lecture, we will introduce one more data type called Boolean. Let's add one more variable, B1. Now, this particular data type has only two different values. One is true, other is false. Let's say B1 is equal to true and B2 is equal to false. Let's print B1 and B2. Let's execute this particular program. As expected, the data type for variables B1 and B2 is Boolean. This is a different kind of data type where any variable created using this particular data type can hold only two different values, which is true or false. And notice carefully that the letter T in true and letter F in false has to be capital. Otherwise, it will not be considered as Boolean. Now, as we have studied four different data types, let's try something different, which is data conversion from one data type to other. First, let's start with integers. Let's look at this particular code. Value 5.7 is of type float. But we are explicitly telling the computer to convert this 5.7 to integer and then store it in variable A. Similarly, over here, 10 is an integer, but it is currently enclosed in single quotes, which means it is string. And we are asking computer to convert this string into integer and then store it in variable B. Computer will convert 5.7 into integer, string 10 into an integer, and ultimately variables A and B should be integers. Let's print the values of A and B, also the type of A and type of B, and let's see how it works. As you can see, value of variable A is 5 and type is integer, whereas value for variable B is 10 and type is integer. In the case of conversion from float to integer, computer will only take 5 and store it in A, whereas this 0.7 part will be ignored. This is how we can convert a float or a string into an integer. Now let's look at similar type of conversion from integer and string to float. Let's look at this particular code where 9 is integer and 5.3 is a string. But we are telling the computer to convert both these values from integer to float and then from string to float. Let's execute the code. As expected, the original value 9 got converted to 9.0 and type is float. A string representation of 5.3 got converted to its float representation, which is again 5.3, but the type had changed to float. This is how we can convert values from integer or from string to its equivalent float representation. Now, let's see how to convert values of type integer and float to its equivalent string representation. Once again, this 9 is an integer and 5.3 is a float. But we are telling the computer to convert this 9 to a string, also 5.3 to a string. Let's execute the code. As expected, we got the output as 9 and 5.3, but the type has been converted from integer to string and then from float to string. This data type conversion is generally referred as type conversion or type casting, as in conversion from one data type to other data type. If you have noticed, so far we are trying to convert values between integers, floats and strings, but we haven't discussed any type conversion related to Boolean data type. Let's see how type conversion can be done from integers, floats and strings to Boolean data type. Let's look at this particular code where we are trying to convert three different integer values to its equivalent Boolean values. Boolean of 10, then 0, minus 10. Let's first execute this code and then we'll see how a particular output is coming. Class or type of variables A, B and C is Boolean, but if you observe the values, then you will notice there is some difference. It says true, false and true. Value for variable B is coming out to be false, whereas values for variables A and C are true. This is happening because whenever computer converts an integer to a Boolean, all values except 0 are considered as true, whereas 0 is the only value which will give us a Boolean representation which is false. That's the reason 10 as well as minus 10 are getting converted to Boolean value true, whereas 0 is getting converted to Boolean value false. Now let's try the similar thing with a floating point value. Now let's look at this particular code where we are converting values from float data type to Boolean data type. Let's execute. Once again, a data type has been converted from float to Boolean in all three cases, whereas the values for variables A and C are true, but for variable B it is still false because 0.0 is nothing but 0 only. And as we have mentioned earlier, Boolean representation of 0 is always false. Other than that, for all other positive as well as negative numbers, irrespective of integer or float, we will get a Boolean representation as true. Now let's see what happens when we try to convert string to Boolean. Let's look at this particular code block. India, 10, minus 10.4, as well as 0, all are strings. And we are trying to convert all these string values to its equivalent Boolean representation. Let's execute the code and see what kind of output we are getting. All data types are Booleans and all values are true. Now, even in the case of 0, it is giving value true because in this case, 0 is neither an integer nor a float. Here, 0 is enclosed in this single quotes, which makes it a string. And string representation of Boolean is always true except for one condition. Let's see what that condition is. E is equal to Boolean of empty string. Here we are simply giving single quotes, and inside those single quotes we are not writing anything, which means it is an empty string, and a Boolean conversion of empty string is false, as you can see over here in last line of the output. A class is Boolean, but the value is false. All strings are converted to Boolean with value true except an empty string. So in order to summarize this particular lecture, we saw one more new data type called Boolean, and also we studied type conversion within integer, float and string, and at the end we converted all different types of integers, floats and strings to its equivalent Boolean representation. Thank you for watching this lecture. Happy learning.